The man who chases two rabbits catches none. Starting an e-commerce social media marketing agency without picking a sub-niche is absolutely one of the most detrimental things you could do for your success. It's what I did at the start, and I see so many people do this. They think that e-commerce is a social media marketing niche, and that is completely not true. E-commerce is purely a sector that hosts millions of different brands, and within that sector, there's so many sub-niches. And it wasn't until I got laser focused in one single sub-niche that I started seeing incredible results with my marketing agency and scaled my agency well past that six-figure mark. That is the outcome that I want for you guys. And so in this video, I'm gonna share with you, number one, why picking a sub-niche within e-commerce is by far the easiest edge you can get as a beginner agency owner. Number two, how to go about deciding on your sub-niche. And number three, the best sub-niches in the e-commerce sphere, why I recommend them and why you could possibly give them a try. So I'm super excited for this video. It's going to be very in-depth and you guys are going to be able to walk away with actionable strategies, stuff that took me literally 2 years to learn and implement them on your agency to get incredible results. So without further ado, let's get right into it. So the first thing that I want you guys to understand is why it's actually incredibly vital to pick a sub-niche. Because it's all fun and games, I can tell you all these sub-niches that are best to pick and the most profitable ones, but if you guys don't understand why it's incredibly important to pick a sub-niche, then there's really not much point to that. And so to explain the importance of it, let's analyze your situation. You might have a few clients under your belt, you might have zero clients under your belt, right? But when you typically start your agency, you don't have testimonials, you don't have clients, you don't have experience, right? And so you really lack social proof and authority. What you do have is hunger to succeed.
It's hunger.
Now, when I started my e-commerce agency, I wanted to go for the big brands, the brands that could really excite me and fulfill my team, right? I didn't really want to work for those small brands that didn't quite fulfill me. Yes, we have some smaller brands under our agency, right? But the brands that I truly believe in, that I really get along with the founder team, and that truly, truly fulfills us, right? But I didn't want to work with brands that didn't truly fulfill me, that didn't have a great product. And so if you're going for the bigger brands and brands that really have an incredible product, you are going to be going up against other agencies. It's just the nature of business, right? The B2B space is competitive, just like any other space, and you should not shy away from that. In fact, you should embrace competition. I think it's great because it makes you so much better. And so imagine me, a beginner agency owner. I didn't have much experience. I didn't really have any testimonials. And so I started thinking about the agencies that I was going up against, right? And so if you're reaching out to a bigger client, they probably have other agencies reaching out to them, right? What type of agencies are usually reaching out to these prospects? Number one, we've got what I call the do-it-all agency, right? They do dentists, they serve clinics, they serve restaurants, they serve a bunch of e-commerce brands. They pretty much work with any business under the sun, right? And so that's the first type of agency. The second type of agency is an e-commerce agency, right? A 360 e-commerce agency. And so they work with a bunch of tech brands, they work with a bunch of health clients, wellness brands, a bunch of apparel and fashion brands. And so they have a bunch of different sub-niches that they work with. And so when I was thinking about the edge that I could get, I turned to psychology to find my answer. And I learned about this thing called the in-group, out-group bias. And what it means is that we tend to favor people that share similar interests, similar traits, and similar characteristics with us, right? And so I asked myself, how can I get an edge over these people that have a bunch of testimonials, a bunch of experience, they've been around for a while, they've worked with a bunch of different clients. How could I possibly get an edge over these people? And the answer was by narrowing down into a sub-niche, because I just knew how important it was to speak the prospect's language. And I knew that if I just narrow down into a single sub-niche, I could brand myself as an expert in that niche and set myself apart from other agencies and get the easiest and fastest edge that I've ever gotten in my agency career, just by narrowing down into a specific sub-niche. Because yes, the prospect gets the outreach from agencies that are more well-established, right? But they also get my outreach from an agency that specifically works within that sub-niche. And so that gave me a massive edge. And to wrap this point up, that is why it's incredibly important to pick a sub-niche. And I'm telling you guys from experience, I'm telling you because this was a massive breakthrough in my business. And so that's really the first thing that I want you guys to keep in mind, why it's incredibly important to pick a sub-niche. And with that being said, let's get right into the next point. The next point is dropping a big thumbs up. YouTube just loves when that thing turns blue. It really helps out a ton with the algorithm. So if you haven't done so already and you're enjoying this video, go ahead and drop a big thumbs up. And with that being said, let's go right into the second point. The second point is deciding on your sub-niche. And there's a few things that you want to keep in mind. The first thing is there any passion of yours that you already have? Is there any hobby of yours that comes to mind, right? Or is there anything that you know a bit about? Now, the knowing a bit about something part is not incredibly vital because you're going to always learn. But if there's already something that you're attracted to, maybe fitness, maybe health, right? Maybe apparel and fashion. You absolutely love fashion. Then it's a really good idea to go down that route because you already speak the prospect's language and it's going to come more natural to you to learn about the competitors, to know about the brands, to know about the different movements. More importantly, what customers value, because you are a customer of that specific sub niche already. So that's the first thing that you want to keep in mind. And the second thing is, can it be monetized? And can it be monetized very well? So those are the two things that you want to keep in mind. And with that being said, what you've all been waiting for, the best sub niches to pick in e-commerce in 2020. So the way I'm going to do this is, for every single sub niche, I'm going to walk you through the pros and the cons. Obviously, the cons are going to outweigh the pros. Otherwise, I wouldn't have picked these niches, but I just want you to have that awareness of why I actually picked them. Now, the first niche is tech. And here I'm talking tech gadgets, wearables, audio devices, etc., etc. Now, the reason why we like tech as a sub niche is because, number one, usually brands have a product that really stands out, that really offers something new to the market. This is, for example, not the case in other sub niches, like, for example, apparel and fashion, which is a great sub niche. But what makes you stand out in apparel and fashion, for example, is the brand image and the story that you tell. But when it comes to tech, the storytelling is obviously very important, but the product does a lot of the selling. And not only that, but what I've seen in successful tech brands is that they usually have really good video content conveying all the specs and the benefits of the product, which do absolutely great when it comes to Facebook advertising. So that's the first thing. And the second thing why I like tech as a sub niche is because it has a high average order value, and that typically means that it's easier to get a higher ROAS. The reason why this is because products can range from $100 to even $500, and so you could even spend $100 to acquire a customer, which is pretty high, right, when it comes to Facebook advertising. But if that customer goes on to spend $400, $500, then it's actually easier to get a high ROAS with a higher average order value. The only con that I see with tech as a sub niche is that obviously it has a longer sales process. And the reason why this is because the more people spend on a product, the longer they have to think about it. And so typically you have to have a longer sales process with more touch points and impressions with them. Simply said, it's just not an impulse buy. So that is the first sub niche. And the second sub niche is health and wellness. And the first reason why I love health and wellness is because they have high replenishment rates. And what this means is that people go on to buy more and more later down the line, right? So if, for example, you're working for a supplement brand and you acquire a customer for $5 profit, right? Sure, you might make $5 on the front end, but that customer is going to go ahead and spend $100, $200 as a lifetime value. And so for the client, this is incredible because, yes, as long as you're breaking even or being profitable on the front end, that's great for you as an agency, right? Because the vast majority of the money they're going to make on the lifetime value of that customer that you brought them. So that's great for the brand, and that's also great for you because you're not pressured to make incredible returns on the front end. You can just go ahead and think more long term, which is usually the much better option. The other reason why I like health and wellness is because at the time I'm recording this, it's a bit of a trend right now, and I truly believe the general consciousness is growing around health and wellness. People want to be healthy, people want to take care of themselves, especially with the current landscape and the pandemic. And so it's a growing market. And the reason why I love it is because you can actually convey the benefits and how it can change someone's life to get healthier, right? And so it lends itself for great storytelling. And so it's also a bit of an impulse buy, which is great as an advertiser. The only con that I've seen with working with a lot of brands in the health and wellness space is that the CPMs are higher, which means that it costs us more to get in front of people. And the reason why that is because there's quite a bit of competition. So it's a bit harder to be widely profitable on the front end. But that's completely fine because the lifetime value will take care of you. So that's the second niche. And the third niche is the apparel and fashion space. And the reason why I love this niche is because they're already sold on the service. They already know how important it is to get in front of a lot of eyeballs when you are a fashion brand. And the reason why this is goes back to the concept that I was talking to you about when I was talking about tech. The fact that with tech, the product pretty much sells itself, but with fashion, you really need to sell the mission, the values, the philosophy, the way you guys do things differently, the brand image, right? It's all about the brand image. And so to do that, you're going to have to pay your way to get in front of as many eyeballs as possible because your product doesn't really have that viral component to it. And so storytelling is absolutely key. And the second pro of the apparel and fashion space is that there's an abundance of prospects. There's a ton of fashion brands out there that you can reach out to and that you can work with. So those are the pros. And the cons is, number one, the profit margins tend to be pretty low. And the second thing is that competition tends to be pretty high. But as long as you have great storytelling, you can still succeed. You can still get incredible results for your prospects. So guys, those are the best and most profitable sub niches for e-commerce. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and drop a big thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. It really helps out a ton with the algorithm and the channel. So I really, really appreciate it. Also, leave down below any comments, any questions you may have on this video, and I'll be sure to check those out. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, there's so much content on entrepreneurship and a 360 approach to social media marketing agency with a specific focus on e-commerce, sales, and outreach. And so if you don't want to miss any of that, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And the final thing is, if you haven't joined the free private mentorship community on Facebook, the Client Closers, it's an incredible community full of like-minded people looking to scale their agency and level up in life. I am doing free trainings, free interviews in there. I'm doing free Ask Me Anythings in there. So if you want to check it out, go ahead and check out the link in the description. Go ahead and apply. And if you're a good fit, we'll let you in. And as always, guys, hope everything is going well in your journey. And I will see you in the next one. Peace.